will surprise you all. I'm rather sorry I can't be there to see your reactions. The reason I decided to have my will read before the funeral was quite simply to put you out of your misery. I know you've all suffered a great deal during the past few months, wondering just which way things might go for you. Bet you're feeling nervous. Patricia? Stephen? How about you, Barbara? Amanda? And I can just imagine Wayne. Well, I suppose we'd better get on with it. Now, firstly, Barbara, and that, of course, includes Gordon. Neither of you has ever been interested in my money, so you're not getting any. Not that you need it, anyway. Barbara, I'm leaving you my jewelry, which I'd like passed on to your daughters when the time comes. Right. Stephen, you're next. Stomach churning a bit, I should imagine. I think you proved that you're quite capable of looking after yourself, so I don't see the need to leave you anything. You've had all the money in the world to play with while I've been alive. And as you managed to go through your father's inheritance so quickly, I don't really think you have much chance of contesting my will. Not that I think you would. Good taste would surely prevail. I thought, for sentimental reasons, you and Patricia might like to have my portrait. Now, Amanda, I'm sure you're there with your new husband by now, I imagine. You'll be pleased to know I've kept my word. You receive half of my assets, plus the house here in Melbourne and the apartment in Sydney, on condition, of course, that you give birth to a son fathered by Wayne Morrell within 12 months. I've made sure there's enough money in the meantime to keep you both comfortable, and when your son's born, you'll get the rest. I suppose you're all wondering what happens if they don't have a son. Their share goes to charity. The remainder of my estate goes to two people. They will share the other half of my assets. Also, along with Wayne, they will each take a third share in my business interests. The first is one of the most honest people I've ever met, and for that alone, Beryl Palmer should be rewarded.
I don't understand.
What? It's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
Ladies and gentlemen, if we could proceed quietly, there isn't much further to go.
I bet that caused a bit of a to-do. You deserve it, Beryl. Look after yourself, my dear. The last person to benefit from the estate, the other person to share, as with Beryl Palmer, a third of the business and half my other assets, is someone who has shown through her life extraordinary devotion to her parents. Something which I find admirable. She has also had great misfortune. And hopefully, this will help her get back on her feet. You'll be delighted to know, Patricia, I'm sure, that the person is your sister, Margaret Dunn.